Now that the project has a horizon applied to it, let's start drawing the scene for our project to incorporate near shading. In this tutorial, we will draw the house and the PV array. To start, let's create a new variant. To do this, click Save, type the name of the new variant, Tutorial with Near Shading, and click Save as New. Click on Near Shadings, and click on Construction/Perspective to open the Shading Scene Construction tool. Now we have to draw the scene for our project. Open the PDF document describing the project plan. We will start by drawing the building. From this compass on the project document, we can see that we are going to have to rotate the scene after drawing it. PVsyst allows us to draw our scene from the building reference and then rotate it to the geographical coordinates. To do this, make sure that the building reference is selected before you start drawing the building. Then click on Create and select Building/Composed Object. This opens a secondary 3D window in the reference coordinate system of the new building object. Click on Add Object and select Parallelepiped and set the sizes for one wing of the building in the drawing. Click Close Object, and the wing is placed in the coordinate system of the building. To create the second wing, follow the same steps. The only difference is that we will use a length of 25 meters. Now we have to position the second wing properly. To do this, make sure to select the smaller of the two wings. Note that to select objects, you have to click on the wireframe borders. Click on Top View. Click on the Move Selection tool, or use the shortcut Ctrl B. To move the item, you can click on the arrows to move in a specific direction. You can also move the item freely along both axes by clicking on the square. Move the smaller wing to the left of the larger wing. To rotate the wing, click on the Rotate Selection tool or use the shortcut Ctrl R. If you hold Shift as you rotate, the building will only rotate in steps of 5 degrees. Otherwise, you can rotate with much finer precision. You may have to move the wing down to put it roughly in the correct place. Once your wing is roughly in the correct place, you can set the modifications exactly using the Move and Rotate frame. In our case, the wing should be placed at exactly a position of 10 meters for X, 10 meters for Y, and an azimuth of 90 degrees. Click on the standard perspective, or use the shortcut F2 to see the building. Now we have to add the roof. Click on Add Object and choose Two-sided roof plus gables. Select the base width as 11 meters and the top length as 30.5 meters. Our roof should be at an angle of 25 degrees. In order to match the roof properly, we will need a negative 45 degree gable on one side. Click Close Object. This time, we can directly use the positioning values to properly place the roof. It should be at X 5 meters, Y 5 meters, and Z 5 meters. To create the other roof wing, we can copy and paste this one using Edit Copy and Edit Paste. Rotate and position the roof on the top of the other wing. After this, we realize that we have to change the gable angle. To modify the roof, either right-click on the object and select Modify Object, or simply double-click on the object. You can also select the object and use the shortcut Ctrl M. Change the gable angle from negative 45 degrees to positive 45 degrees, and close the object. Position the object correctly and click the perspective view to view the house. Close the object, and now the house is placed in the main drawing. Next, let's add the PV plane. Choose Create, Rectangular PV Plane, Single or Multiple. In our case, we are only using a singular rectangular field, so the number of rectangles should stay at 1. Our roof angle is 25 degrees, so we should keep the plane tilt at 25 degrees. For now, we will leave the azimuth value at 0, but we will modify this once the plane is in the main scene. To define the size of our PV array, we go to the Rect Size tab. From our drawing, we want our array to be around 15 meters by 3.3 meters. From our system design in my first project, we want two strings of 15 modules each. We can achieve both of these requirements by having 15 by 2 modules in portrait mode. In this tutorial, we will leave the module spacing parameters alone. Click Close Object. The plane is aligned to the origin of the 3D scene. Go to the top view to position the panel correctly in the XY plane. You will need to orient the panel to an azimuth of 90 degrees. To position the array vertically, move to the front view. Click on the blue arrow to move the array along the Z axis. Make sure to put the array slightly above the roof. If the array is located within the roof, it will be permanently shaded. Now we have our PV array on our roof. Save the scene by clicking File, Export. This saves the scene in your workspace as a .shd file. From here, it can be loaded and used in other projects as well. In the next tutorial, we will add shading objects to our scene, rotate it, and see how it affects the simulation results.